In this video, we're going to cover some topics related to graphing. We're going to cover a really basic graphing method, and we're going to graph an absolute value equation. We're going to look at the distance formula and an example that uses it. We're going to derive the circle equation, or sometimes known as the standard form of the circle, and we're going to do an example with that as well. In this example, we're going to look at graphing y equal negative 2 times the absolute value of x minus 3. We're going to use that standard method of graphing. It's a method that works for a lot of equations pretty well if you don't have any other method, and that is where you find and plot the intercepts, then you find and plot other points in between intercepts and on each side of the intercepts, and then you draw a smooth curve through from left to right. So let's find the intercepts. The easiest one is the y-intercept, and that's where you let x equal 0. You plug 0 into this equation and you get y equal negative 2 times absolute value of 0 minus 3. Well, 0 minus 3 is negative 3, so we have negative 2 times absolute value of negative 3. But the absolute value makes that negative 3 turn positive, so we get y equal negative 2 times positive 3 equals negative 6. So when x is 0, y is negative 6. And I have that point plotted here. It's on the y-axis. Now, for the x-axis, we let y equal 0. Now, letting y equal 0 results in an equation. We have the equation 0 equal negative 2 times absolute value of x minus 3. Because I took the y out of the original equation and replaced it with 0. Now, that's an absolute value equation. We start off by dividing both sides by negative 2 to get the absolute value by itself. You get 0 equal absolute value of x minus 3. Now, if you remember, for solving absolute value equations, you have two cases, positive and negative. Well, in this case, we get positive 0 equal x minus 3 and negative 0 equal x minus 3. Well, negative 0 is still 0, so we really only have one case here, 0 equal x minus 3. Or that gives us an answer of x equals 3. So our x-intercept is 3, 0, and I have that plotted up here. Now we have to find more points. Now, so far we just have two points. That really doesn't give us a graph. We let x equal 4. When x is 4, we get y equal negative 2 times the absolute value of 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3 is 1, so we get negative 2 times 1, or negative 2. So that gives us the point 4, negative 2, and I'm going to drag it over here and plot it. 4, negative 2, it's right about there. Okay, the next point, we let x equal 1. We want to get at least one point in between those intercepts. When x is 1, we plug 1 into our equation and we get negative 2 times the absolute value of 1 minus 3. Well, 1 minus 3 is negative 2. And the absolute value of negative 2 is positive 2. So our y value is negative 2 times 2, or negative 4. So when x is 1, y is negative 4. And I'm going to plot that value in here. Okay, 1, negative 4. Right about there. Then we want a few more points. Maybe this is actually enough points to give you the graph, but we'll find maybe two more just to be sure. When x is 5, we get negative 2 times absolute value of 5 minus 3 for the y value. 5 minus 3 is 2. Negative 2 times 2 is negative 4. So when x is 5, y is negative 4. And we can plot that point. 5, negative 4, and it's right about there. And then one more point, when x is negative 1, we plug in negative 1 into our equation, and we get y equal negative 2 times negative 1 minus 3, or absolute value of negative 1 minus 3. Negative 1 minus 3 is negative 4. The absolute value of negative 4 is positive 4, so y equals negative 2 times positive 4, or negative 8, when x is negative 1. So then we plot that last point. That ends up being here somewhere. Now I'll draw a smooth curve through from left to right. I'll use a green line, and it looks like it goes through right about there, and then it bounces off the x-axis and then goes down. And as is the case with absolute value graphs, they have a V shape and they bounce off some horizontal line or the x-axis. And that's what we get here. Let's take a look at the distance formula. The distance formula is nothing more than an application of the Pythagorean theorem. The distance formula says the distance from point x1, y1 to x2, y2 is equal to the square root of y2 minus y1 squared plus x2 minus x1 squared. Well, down here I have point x1, y1 plotted and point x2, y2 plotted. And if we look at that distance between the two points, we can construct a right triangle. If we look at the bottom side of this right triangle, the length of that side is really x2 minus x1. Well, off to the corner here, I have another triangle, and I label that side A. The other side of this right triangle has length y2 minus y1, the difference in the y values. I have the other triangle here on the side labeled B. Well, by the Pythagorean theorem, A squared plus B squared equals C squared. In our distance application, D is the hypotenuse, or D squared is equal to x2 minus x1 quantity squared plus y2 minus y1 quantity squared. In our Pythagorean theorem example off to the corner here, when we square root both sides, we get C equals the square root of A squared plus B squared. Well, in our distance formula, we take the square root of both sides and we get D equals the square root of those two squared differences. Now let's look at an example with the distance formula. We're going to find the distance from the point 3, negative 2 to 5, negative 6. All we really have to do is plug in the values. y2 is negative 6, y1 is negative 2. We plug in negative 6 minus a negative 2. We plug in x2 minus x1, which is 5 minus 3. 6 minus negative 2 ends up being negative 4, so we have negative 4 squared inside the radical plus 2 squared inside the radical. That gives us square root of 20, and if we want a decimal answer, we're going to have to round it off, and the decimal answer would be 4.472. The distance formula leads into the equation of a circle. A circle of radius r centered at hk is defined as all points xy that are a distance r units away from that center hk. So if we let the distance from each point hk to each point xy be equal to r, and we plug those values into the distance formula, we get y2 minus y1 is y minus k quantity squared, and x2 minus x1 is x minus h, and then we square and take square root. We let that radical equal r, our distance, we get r equal the square root of y minus k squared plus x minus h quantity squared. Now if we square both sides of that, we get our circle equation. X minus h quantity squared plus y minus k quantity squared equals r squared. We can use that formula in the following example. Let's say we have a circle with center 3, negative 1, and it has a radius of 2. What is the equation of that circle? Well, in this case, the center is 3, negative 1, so hk is 3, negative 1, h is 3, k is negative 1. Our r value is 2, and we just plug these values into our circle equation, and we get x minus 3 quantity squared plus y minus a negative 1 quantity squared equals 2 squared. And if we simplify this, we get x minus 3 quantity squared plus y plus 1 quantity squared equals 4. And we can graph that circle just by plotting the center at 3, negative 1, and then going 2 units in each direction. We can go 2 units up from the center to get another point. We can go 2 units to the right from the center to get another point. Go 2 units to the left. And go 2 units down, and we get 4 points that define the circle. And here are the points shown.